What's new in macOS Ventura? A whole lot, it would seem, including some much-loved iOS features that are now available on macOS. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today, I'm sharing the best macOS Ventura tips and tricks. Let's go! Before we begin, if you haven't updated to macOS Ventura yet, there are crucial steps you need to take prior to upgrading. So I've made a video on the 5 steps you need to take before upgrading to Ventura. So if you haven't, make sure you watch that video first and then come back here. So right off the bat, I think a really big difference in Ventura is that System Preferences is now System Settings. Here's what this looks like. In your dock or from your Apple menu in the top left, you may notice System Preferences has been replaced by System Settings. When we click on this, your new System Settings window looks a little bit different. It kind of looks a little bit more like what we're used to seeing on iOS rather than macOS. And while we're in these System Settings, why don't we explore one of my favorite new Ventura features. macOS Ventura now allows you to enable background sounds. This is wild. From our System Settings, click on Accessibility. Then toggle on the Background Sounds option. So what this is doing is masking background noise and outside distractions by playing sounds to keep you focused. So think like rain or a stream or the sound of the ocean, perhaps. So we toggle on background sounds. And now if I've got my volume on properly, you should hear the sound of a calm running stream. And if you don't want to stream, you can click on choose. And in this pop-up, select the background sound you'd like from the list. So maybe I'd rather have rain or ocean. This sounds weird, but I love this when I'm scripting because when I'm writing, I can't listen to music because oftentimes I'll end up writing the lyrics to the song rather than the script I'm timed to write. Whoops. So with background sounds, now I can have something playing that's not distracting rather than my normal ears ringing or being distracted by the dog or the cat or the 75 other distractions that happen during my day. But moving on, another new addition to macOS Ventura is Stage Manager. This is like a new way to manage your windows. I kind of think of it really similar to how I like to use hot corners to switch between apps. From your control center, which you can get to right from the top of your menu bar, you're gonna have a new Stage Manager option. The first time you click on Stage Manager, you'll be given a quick tutorial on how it works and what it looks like. So we can click to turn on Stage Manager to show you what this will be like here. When you have multiple apps open, you're going to have them on the left-hand side, and the current window or app you're in will be moved to center stage, if you will. Just click on one of the apps on the side to bring that app up to the center and send the other one to the side. Now, if you want to have more than one just open, you can do that too. So rather than clicking on the app on the side, you're actually going to drag it to the center of your screen as well. So now these two apps are kind of grouped together. So if I click on another app on the side, you're gonna notice both those apps shrink to the side, and then the app that we've clicked on now comes up to the middle. Remember, you can toggle this on or off as you see fit by using your control center toggle in the menu bar. Now let's move on to some new apps, starting with the clock app. You can get to your clock app from your app menu or from Finder or just using command space and searching for the clock app. Either way, once you click on it, your clock will open and do all the same things that a clock can do on iOS. So you can obviously tell time, duh, it's a clock, or you can set a timer, set an alarm, use stopwatch, and view world clocks. It's really just like you're used to on iOS, but now on Mac. And that's not the only app that's come to macOS. We've now got an all new weather app. So again, there are multiple ways to get to the weather app, but once you open it, it's just like you have on iOS. In fact, whatever cities you have set on your iOS device, you'll have automatically populated over on your Mac as well. And you can click on certain features to get more detailed weather, which is really handy. So now there's no need to Google the weather. You just pull up your app on Ventura. Now this next Ventura feature is for all the mail users out there. You can now schedule emails just like you can on iOS. I know. I don't use Apple Mail, but I am a woman of the people, and this is a macOS video after all. So from your mail app, once you're ready to send, just click on the little drop-down arrow to the right of the send option. This will give you the option to send the email at a predetermined time or to send later and pick a custom time you'd like that email to be sent at. But you can also undo send in mail as well now, just like we can on iOS. So there's actually nothing we have to toggle on for this. It's gonna happen right away for us. When we go to send an email, right away on the bottom, there's an option to undo send. If you click on that option, the email will boop, pop back up for you to make whatever changes you need to make. And I believe you have 10 seconds to do this, by the way. If you wait longer than that, the undo send option will go away, and then that email is sent out, whether you like it or not. But moving on, and you probably know where this is going, you can now also undo send on messages as well, just like we can on iOS 16. So in messages, once you've sent that message that you want to retract, just right click on the message and click on undo send. You're gonna have this option for up to 2 minutes, by the way. After 2 minutes, there are no take backs. And by the way, if the recipient has already seen the message, well, there's nothing you can really do about that. I mean, they've seen it. This is an undo send, not a mind wipe. But there is yet another new messages feature on macOS Ventura. You can now edit your sent messages, finally, just like we can on iOS 16. So again, let's say we've sent a message and whoops, spelling mistake as usual. We'll just right click on that message and select edit. Then we'll edit it to what we're actually trying to say. And voila, the message has been edited. You can edit a message, I believe, up to 5 times within the first 15 minutes of it being sent. And your message will be marked as edited. So those in the chat will know that you've edited the message. And you can actually click where it says edited, and you're gonna see that complete revision history of the message. Woohoo! Another cool update to messages is that you can now filter messages. So from the Messages app, you can click on View at the top, and now you'll have the ability to filter messages by all messages, known senders, unknown senders, or unread messages. This is so helpful if you get a ton of messages in a day and really need to quickly sort through all the backlog. So I feel like that was about 10 macOS Ventura tips and tricks, but I might have saved the best one for you as a little bonus. You can now use your iPhone as your Mac camera. This is something Apple calls Continuity Camera. Now, in order to do this, you're going to have to be running macOS Ventura and iOS 16. Both your Mac and iPhone will need to be signed into the same Apple ID, and your Bluetooth and Wi-Fi will need to be toggled on as well. So on your Mac, all you're gonna have to do is open up any app that has access to the camera. So think like FaceTime or any video chat. We're gonna use, as an example here, QuickTime. So in the recording options, or it may be in the settings section, depending on what app you're using, you should have a new option to use your phone's camera. So we see my phone here, yours would be there. Obviously, you wouldn't have my phone. So just select your phone as the camera option. And just like that, your phone is connected to the camera. This means you could obviously set this up stationary, or you could mosey around your office if you wanted to, or if you want to show something to those on a call. You have complete access to your phone camera. How cool is this? But wait, there's more. When you're using your iPhone as a camera for your Mac, you will have a few other options. Up in our trusty control center, there are a few cool video effects you can use. So we can toggle on center stage, which adjusts the camera to keep you centered as you move in the frame. This is kind of like you're used to on iPadOS as well. I just love this. Or you could select portrait. This is another one we're familiar with from iOS, where it'll soften your background for you. And you can also toggle on studio light. This is an effect for kind of that blinged out light effect. It darkens the background a little bit to keep you highlighted without actually needing an extra light. This is really great if you have iffy lighting situations. But there's another feature with Continuity Cam. Can you believe? It's called Desk View, and it might just blow your mind. So from our control center, in those effects, let's this time click on Desk View. Now, what this is doing is exactly what it sounds like. We're going to be able to show a desk view. So you can use the slider on the bottom of the screen to shrink or expand the edges of your guide box. So you're going to want to get this to where your desk kind of ends. Then click on desk view. Boom, there's now a desk view where I could showcase tech items to you or a cool 11 figurine. So obviously this video quality is not great, but I do imagine that will improve in the future. It's more of just a cool show and tell feature. So those are what I think are the best macOS Ventura tips and tricks. Obviously there are a lot more and I couldn't cover everything in this video. There's just no time. But remember, I've got a link in the description below on what to do before upgrading to macOS Ventura. So be sure to check that out if you haven't upgraded yet. Until then, enjoy. So that's what's new in macOS Ventura. What are your favorite Ventura features? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and wouldn't you know, here and here for even more Mac content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.